everyone. My name is Ayça. I'm Cloud Developer Advocate at Microsoft. And as Vesa mentioned in the session, we will talk about creating your first custom engine agents with Microsoft Teams Toolkit. So this session is a part of Copilot Developer Camp. If you haven't heard of Copilot Developer Camp, I'll show you in a second, but it is a pack of videos and hands-on labs for you to get started building Copilot agents. And our target audience is professional developers and also makers. We have content for both pro code developers and also if you are already experienced in part platform Copilot Studio, then we also have content for you. So there are multi pathways, but in today's session, we will focus on custom engine agents. Custom engine agents in our entire Copilot Developer Camp is the most custom one, as you can tell from the name. And these are the agents that works on Microsoft 365 ecosystem, but they are built using Azure AI Foundry, any model you want, and you can actually bring any orchestrator you want as well. And if you're interested, I will in this session particularly, I will walk you through the prerequisites of building custom engine agents, and then we will build the very first one in the session too. Okay, that was the all PowerPoint I had today, and now we will dive into the Copilot Developer Camp. So if you go to Copilot Developer Camp, we have a bunch of video series available for you, and we also have we also had live stream that you might find it helpful. And in this session particularly, we will focus on build path, which we have the build a custom engine agent session. So these labs, if you follow, you will build a production ready custom engine agent called Career Genie, which is powered by Azure OpenAI. And we will build one of the deployment models using AI Foundry. And then you can integrate Azure AI Search for RAG. You can adjust and change the user experience. You can add single sign-on authentication. And finally, you can add actions for handling complex tasks. In today's session, I will actually show you how you can get started. So this is basically the step zero and step one, but we will have more coming. So every other week, I will be here to talk about B2, B3, B4, and B5, and we will basically build all of them together. In the end of this series, you will have Career Genie working in your own machine. Okay, so when we get started with the prerequisites, it's pretty similar to what Bob showed you last week, and he showed the prerequisites for extend pathway. It is pretty similar setup because we all use Teams Toolkit for building agents. To start with, we need to enable Teams custom application uploads. And to do that, if you go to admin.microsoft.com, you will see under the show all section, there is Microsoft Teams Admin Center. If you go there and select setup policies, the only thing you have to do is enable upload custom apps, and you will be able to test your apps and deploy your apps to Microsoft Teams. And we will also need Teams Toolkit. If you use Teams Toolkit before, you know that Teams Toolkit is an extension in Visual Studio Code, and we are basically using that extension to be able to build agents for our ecosystem. And finally, you need to install Node.js, and to do that, you can just follow this link, and you can download either 18 or 16 that are supported for our agent system. And Teams Toolkit, I think I covered Visual Studio Code part in Teams Toolkit, but vice versa, you need Visual Studio Code and Teams Toolkit together. And after you installed all for this labs in particular, for custom engine agents, you will need Azure subscription. And if you don't have Azure subscription, you can get a free one starting today. And to be able to create the free Azure account, you can just follow these steps. There is an activation here for, I think this is for 30 days, and you will be able to test these labs after completing these steps. And after having all these prerequisites, we are now ready to start with the first custom engine agent. So let's remember what was custom engine agents. Custom engine agents are the agents that we can use. We can basically build using Azure AI Foundry, and we can bring any orchestrator we want. In these labs, we're using Teams AI library and orchestrator behind the AI library, and we are using Azure OpenAI. So the scenario is pretty simple. We actually build a character agent called Career Genie, which helps with the HR queries of the users. So in this case, our HR team is probably asking questions like, can you help me write a job post, et cetera. And the scenarios this agent handles gets more complex and complicated throughout these labs. But because we're in the very first lab, it is pretty simple. So in the first exercise, what we're going to do is we will go to Azure we will go to Azure first, and then we will create Azure OpenAI service. Okay, so I already did that. Let me zoom in a little bit so it's easier for you. I already created Azure OpenAI. Don't ask me why Sweden Central, but there was one service I was trying to get it through and it was only working in Sweden Central. So whichever service you're working with the AI Foundry, you need to make sure that it is working in that region too. That was one of the reasons why I created this in Sweden. But let's quickly go to the AI Foundry and find out how we can create the deployment model. To be able to use the OpenAI model, we actually need to create a deployment model underneath the service. And for today, we will be using GPT-4o, but there are benefits to many other deployment models. For example, so far I have GPT-4, 4o mini, and I also have text embedding Ada. So these all have their own benefits, but in today's exercise, we will particularly use GPT-4o. And I'll select this and confirm. So now, a couple of important points here. The deployment type, we usually recommend global standard and standard if you are not in a production-ready environment. And to be able to customize this, first of all, the version of your model is pretty important. Second of all, the token per minute. So if you increase and decrease this, your limitation from the agent will change. So if you increase this, your agent will be able to answer, let's say, more questions. If you decrease this, you will hit your limitation pretty early in the conversation. So I'm just going to move this slide this on the top, and then create my GPT-4o model. And after that, let's try this in the playground before we jump into building a custom engine agent. As you can see, we are basically using the chat playground. I'll select GPT-4o, the one we've created. And how do we test this? I can either basically put instructions here, or what we can do is we can go to prompt samples, and there are a bunch of samples available here already. So for example, I can select Shakespearean writing assistant, which is definitely not one of my talents. So it can definitely help me write stuff more like a Shakespearean style. And I can use my GPT-4o model and I can test out how this experience looks like. So let's ask something like, tell me about Istanbul. And now the response will be affected by the instructions we give and the examples we give to our model. That means that now the Istanbul is basically explained in a way that the basically Shakespearean style. So everything changes when you change the instructions. You're giving behavior to your model, but in the next step, what we're going to do is we will be bringing this custom experience into Microsoft Teams. Okay, so let me quickly show you where we are in our exercises. So we created a deployment model. We tested the Shakespearean experience. Now it's time to create custom engine agent. And my purpose is basically, if I can click to that, see. Okay, I think I'm clicking the Teams share icon. Let me reshare my desktop. Okay. So the idea is to go to my deployments GPT-4o, bringing this GPT-4o experience into my team's custom engine agent. Okay, so a couple of tips here. If you go to deployments and select your own model, you will be able to find out the language SDK and different types of integrations available. Plus, you can get your endpoint and key right from here as well. Okay, I have my Teams toolkit already installed and Visual Studio Code already installed. So today what we are going to create is not an agent, but custom engine agent. So we will go with basic AI chatbot, but there are multiple options available here. I want to tap into what are the differences. The basic AI chatbot has an integration with Teams AI library, but it doesn't have a complex integration behind the scene. It's just giving you the how AI agent thinks, and it's giving you the consideration behind the model, nothing more. Chat with your data brings us the integration with Azure AI search, where you can bring your data in. An AI agent gives us some of the actions, let's say task-based actions. It's already integrated in this template. So if you want to integrate, let's say creating lists, adding lists, etc., you can get started with this template. Today, we are going to start with basic AI chatbot, and we will implement all these features in the next exercises. So I will select Azure OpenAI. And next step for me is basically taking my key from here and pasting here. And my open, okay, what I want to do is I will actually, so another tip, I just need this URL, not the entire endpoint, because Teams AI library is handling all this behind the scene. And my deployment model is GPT-4o. I can select the default and see a custom engine agent, command calls, and my agent template is scaffolded. Okay, let's quickly have a look what is here. So under the source folder, we have app folder. In app.ts, we have all the integrations from Teams AI library. That means that includes model with Azure OpenAI model. So we are actually using the OpenAI key, deployment name, and endpoint here. Another important part that Teams AI library brings us is the prompts. So prompt manager handles all the prompts under the prompt folder. So today we are using prompt folder. There's a chat folder underneath. That is our default prompt. In the config.json, you will see all the setup for our model, and in the prompt.txt, this is the place where we actually give behavior to our agent, just like in the chat playground where we define instructions. This is the place we also have to define the instructions. So in the Copilot camp, we actually have customized prompt to test this app. I will copy this quickly and paste it here. Okay, let's have a look what is the characteristics of our agent. So your career specialist named Career Genie that helps human resources team with writing job posts. You're friendly, professional, and all use emojis. You're excited, introduce yourself first, et cetera, et cetera. So we are basically giving all these details to the agent so it will behave as it was shared in the prompt. Let's go back to app.ts, and I will quickly run this app before I close out. Finally, we have the storage, and we're using memory storage. This is not recommended for the production purposes, but this is for the demo purpose. And the most important part is our application. So application is the app we are interacting with our AI model. Our AI model is defined, and it's coming from Azure OpenAI. And all the setup is coming from the planner, and everything is basically handled in the planner. So when I say everything is handled in planner is the place where I define model, prompts, and also the default prompt. So when you look back to our model, you will see that all the integration with Azure OpenAI model is handled here. And the second most important thing is all the prompts, which is available under the chat folder today, is also handled under the planner. So if I quickly test this in the test tool today, I should be able to see the behavior right away from our agent. And in the next exercises, we will be continuing testing Career Genie, but moving forward in the next steps, like exercise 2, 3, 4, 5, we will be testing all this in Teams. And if you're lucky enough, and if the service is available in Copilot in the future, we will be also testing Career Genie in Copilot Chat too, which was announced as private preview, but I'm assuming it will be public preview soon as well. Okay, I hope it doesn't take so long. And now we are deploying our agent in a couple of minutes. After testing this, we should be good to hand this over to April. Okay, let's say hi. And if you haven't worked with app test tool before, this is the environment that is mimicking Teams. That means that you don't have to deploy the entire experience of Teams. You don't have to create Teams app ID, bot ID, etc. So everything is basically handled in this local environment where you're basically getting the mimic experience of the AI agent. Okay, so let's see the response. The response is saying, hi there, very friendly using emojis. I'm Career Genie, your friendly expert in crafting top-notch job posts for human resources. This looks pretty nice to me. So I can ask, okay, can you help me write a job post for .NET developer position that requires 8+ years of experience. Let's see if we get a good job post. And as you can see, and I will dive deeper in the next sessions, this agent is already using streaming. That means that we are not sharing everything in one go, but whatever we are getting from the model, we are getting step by step. Okay, and finally, this is the job post we've got for .NET developer, 8+ years. It updated the name as senior, and it gave me a really nice template to get started. So you tell me in the chat if this is a good job post or not. And quickly, before I close out, I want to show you how the streaming experience looks like. So when streaming is enabled for your agent, that means that you're getting not one single answer, but all of the answers step by step. So if you see the chunks here, this is giving you answers in every second. So it's just like the human experience. You are not preparing your paragraph or answer after thinking a couple of minutes. Instead, you're giving your answer step by step into chunks. So we will dive deeper more in the next sessions, and I will be here in the next 30 minutes to answer your questions in the chat. Thank you so much for having me, and I will hand over to April.